Facebook shares recently hit a record high, having quadrupled in value this year alone. And the company has recently established itself as one of the world's leading providers of products and services in the fast-growing mobile communications business. Konstantinos Papadimitrakopoulos is the chief executive, and he joins us now with more. A great story. And investors that have been in the stock a while have seen some tremendous returns if they're still there in the stock. You've recently raised £24 million, I think around about 71 pence in a share placing. Yes. The strength of this demand was fairly impressive, indicating, of course, people are happy with the growth the company's having. Where would you, how would you describe where Globo is?
Having run a significant turnaround of the business since we floated in the AIM market back in 2007, almost 6 years back, Globo has achieved tremendous growth momentum and has entered into a very important market, which is the consumer and enterprise mobility. So the first stages were difficult. We had to reassure everybody that we had the right technology and that we had a scalable business model, and that was achieved mainly because of the emerging markets product that we are still offering in more than 32 countries, and it's still experiencing 22% year-on-year growth. But the most recent development, which is the Go Enterprise solution, focusing on bring your own device trend and mobile application development platforms, is something very, very important, which actually now gives us a full opportunity to claim one of the biggest parts of the market of enterprise mobility, which is just evolving.
This is quite difficult for some people to understand, that the rate at which you're growing. What would you say to those interested to find out more about the working capital? Because this is one of the big questions, isn't it, about what you've got, the receivables and so forth. How do you, what do you say to investors about what's going on?
First of all, investors need to understand what the working capital exercise is compiled from. Our business has actually three main revenue streams. One is coming from Citroen Go business, which is conducted to emerging markets. So for that, the working capital cycle is longer due to the fact that we have to reconcile the usage and the fees that we are receiving from value-added services provider globally with their mobile network operators. So this is a larger working capital cycle. A second, less larger, is the Go Enterprise project business, which is actually projects that we develop for customers, large-scale customers, that use Go Enterprise technology, and we build on top of them certain applications. And the shortest working capital cycle is the Go Enterprise licenses. The Go Enterprise licenses actually accounted for around 53-54% of our interim result this year on Go Enterprise revenue. So it still represents a small portion of the whole business, but it's growing. And eventually, as this becomes more and more strong, this will actually result in a slower, in a faster collection cycle than usually. Now, you have also to understand that the growth pace that the company has of 52% year on year for this half, and probably bigger on the years to come, will also demand some working capital spending there, because eventually building up sales is the biggest factor for success as we speak today. As we have entered and we are one of the leaders in this enterprise mobility markets globally, and we aim to sustain this leadership by investing more and more in our sales and business development.
Well, it's interesting because it's not just internal growth, is it? You're growing by acquisition as well, quite impressively, because you've had this acquisition of the Silicon Valley-based Notified technology for the Go Enterprise suite. This is, helps your push into the US, of course.
Yes.
That's the first thing. I think, what, about 1,800 clients, I think,
yes,
there you've got tapped into now, haven't you? How is this all going to fit in? How long is it going to take to get this in as part of the Globo family of businesses?
We eventually bought the assets and the business of the company, so all this is now reversed into a subsidiary of Globo in US. So the integration has already started. I think we are very, very comfortable to see that the full integration will take us less than three months. Wow. Moreover, wow. The integration of Notify's platform, the Notify MDM product, which was the missing piece of our technology, is already happening. We just showed to Mobile Cone CTIA in San Jose last week. We demonstrated the whole solution and everybody was excited.
What do you say to investors about how this is going to make a difference to them? Those are investors in Globo already.
Exactly.
How does it make a difference?
This is what we are actually looking at now. Till today, with our technology, the container-based solution from Go Enterprise, we could only pitch into the so-called bring-your-own-device trend. We just need to understand what are the two major trends around enterprise mobility. The first trend is the so-called bring your own device, which means that the employee has his own phone and he brings it into the business. So there is a problem, ethical and technical problem. In one side, the business should not have any access to the personal content, and on the other side, the business should have full control on the enterprise applications and content that sits on the employee's phone. So on a technical basis, the Go Enterprise solution is the absolute fit for that because we do a containerized approach, so all enterprise application and content is contained within a secure application, and outside of this application, the whole world of the personal phone exists. Now, this is the area that we have been working for so long. And obviously there is a tremendous trend around this area, and a lot of people, a lot of companies are switching from corporate liable phones to employee liable phones. But there are still a lot of companies that want to have full ownership of the phone and full control of the phone. So this means, like in the case of BlackBerry's, that you have a platform behind the phone that controls the whole functionality, where you make calls, if it's roaming, where you have 3G or Wi-Fi, what kind of browsing, what kind of applications, everything. So to do that, you actually need a platform which is called MDM, Mobile Device Management. This was an area that till now we couldn't even address because we didn't have this platform. With the acquisition of Notify and eventually with the acquisition of the Notify MDM, which is now renamed into Go Enterprise MDM, right. We actually have the opportunity to tap into this market, which till now we haven't been exploiting at all. And as a result, some of the times we could not convince customers to come to us because they were more oriented around the mobile device management that they used to know through the BlackBerry solution.
So as chief executive, what's your priority now? Where do you go from here? What's interesting you most and where do you see most growth?
We have two major poles of development. The first one is the geographical development and the other one is the product development. On a geographical basis, we now see that the company has matured enough. With the acquisition of Notify, we have put another 52 headcount in the US, and we are increasing that significantly. So this is something that gives us much more big visibility on the US market and the enterprise market. So I would say that on a geographical basis, we're going to move closer to the Western economies, Western Europe, UK, and US, of course, as a major driver because it's the most sophisticated and ready to tap into market. On the other side, technology development, we aim to continue to invest in technology because this is the only way to survive within this industry. We have already till today succeeded in a very, very good leadership, I would say, in bringing solutions that still make a difference into the market, and we aim to continue to do that. One new addition to this, apart from the Notify MDM, which is now Go Enterprise MDM, so it's a significant addition, there is the addition of the Go App Zone Studio, which is actually the mobile application development platform that has been upgraded to HTML5 programming, giving us access to millions of developers worldwide. And we're going to launch this product within the next couple of months and provide full access of all potential HTML5 developers to that so that we will bring more and more awareness around our product and eventually convert these users to paying users.
Well, look, it's a pleasure talking to you, Costis, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Konstantinos Papadimitrakopoulos is Chief Executive of Globo.